During World War II, the Japanese didn't really develop any armored cars or armored personnel carriers on a large scale. What they did have were some limited produced vehicles like the Type 93, the Toyota armored car, and a few railway cars like the Type 91 Komo. They also bought 11 British-made Vickers Crossley armored cars and called them the Type 87. Reconnaissance vehicles were also really rare. They did have some APC prototypes in development, but the army didn't see any value in a slow-moving armored troop carrier, so these projects were cancelled. But if you want to know more about armored car development and other APCs, have a look at my Mitsubishi Type 98 video. The Kuragan Type 95 or the Yonki was the only scout car developed by the Japanese Army. The Type 95 was a 3-person 4-wheel drive vehicle which had a 2-cylinder air-cooled engine. The air-cooled engine proved to work really well in the tropical climate and kept the engine from overheating. It also proved to work really well in extreme rough terrain. The Type 95 was the first 4-wheel drive vehicle of this type placed into mass production. It was developed by Toyota in 1934, which at the time was producing the Type G1 truck. The G1 eventually developed into the KB and KC series of military trucks. Even though the Type 95 performed pretty well in the early part of the war, the vehicle proved to have little value in the later years because they had little to no armor. And the lack of having no real armor reconnaissance vehicles began to show. After World War II, Japan was stripped from all its military power, and when the Korean War broke out, the US government felt the need that Japan should have a mass-produced vehicle that would match the Willys specifications. This vehicle could be used by the civilian population and by the Japanese army if a communist invasion would ever reach the mainland. This brought forward the BJ series of vehicles. The BJ Land Cruiser was based on a chassis of the Toyota SB, and after several test runs, the BJ prototype proved to perform better than its American counterpart, and Toyota started its mass production in 1953. The Land Cruiser was used for military and civilian use and would turn out to be the longest continuous produced vehicle in Toyota history. In the 1970s, the need for a new 4-wheel drive vehicle was evident, and the Japanese Ground Self-Defense Force turned to Mitsubishi to develop a new vehicle that was based on the Jeep CJ3BS series, which Mitsubishi was producing at the time on the license from Willys. After several tests, the Type 73 light truck went into production in 1973, and it had a Mitsubishi 4-cylinder diesel engine with a total of 123 horsepower. Even though Japan wasn't allowed to ship any military products out of Japan because of the arms export ban set up after the war, the Type 73 is one of the only military vehicles that could be shipped out of Japan and served in the Vietnam War. In 1996, the Type 73 Shin version went into production and the light truck was slowly phased out. The Shin was an upgraded version that could carry the new FN Mini light machine gun. The Type 73 production stopped in 1997, but it's still in use with the Japanese Ground Self-Defense Force to this day. The Toyota HMV Kokidosha is an infantry transport heavy-duty 4-wheel drive vehicle introduced by Toyota in 1995 and would replace the Type 73 Jugata. It was based on the Hummer H1 and the civilian Toyota Mega Cruiser. The HMV is one of the largest 4-wheel drive vehicles ever built by Toyota and is used in large numbers in the military even though it failed as a civilian sold Mega Cruiser. The standard conversion can accommodate a driver and 9 passengers, and it also can be converted as a shelter carrier and can be equipped with air defense missiles. And that's the version we're looking at today at the Public Information Center. It's not known when the vehicle entered service, even though the Mecha Cruiser was a failure on the Japanese market more because of its size, the HMV is still being used in the Japanese ground defense force today. The Japanese Komatsu light armored vehicle was designed by Komatsu in the late 1990s, after the need for a four-wheel drive light armored vehicle, because the Type 73 light truck wasn't adequate enough to be up-armored. It went into production in 1997 and entered service with the Japanese Ground Self-Defense Force in 2002. The Komatsu can be compared with the Panhard VBL used by the French Army, but it's not known if it was actually based on the Panhard. It's powered by a 160 diesel engine with a top speed of 100 km an hour. The engine was moved closer to the vehicle center to distribute weight more evenly between the axes, has a low turning radius, and is fitted with all run flat tires. It's also light enough to be airdropped from a transport aircraft using a parachute platform. It can be armed with the 5mm or 12mm Sumitomo machine guns, or the Type 1 Kawasaki Type 87 anti-tank missiles. The roof-mounted shielding can be applied to add extra protection, and the opening of the roof hatches provides additional protection from side to side. The Komatsu is one of the few vehicles that would actually see some action outside of Japan and was used in Kuwait and Iraq for humanitarian operations. This is extraordinary because of Japan's laws that don't allow export of weapons and military equipment outside of Japan, and because of the many laws the Japanese Ground Self-Defense Force is bound to after World War II. During these operations, the Japanese forces weren't allowed to fire back at any of the Iraqi insurgents, making them prime targets. Since 1997, 2,000 of these vehicles were produced, but in 2019 Komatsu announced it will no longer develop new models of this light armored vehicle and production was stopped overall. But this is where I leave you with some more footage of this vehicle at the Information Center. So thanks for watching this series of videos. I know that many of you have been asking to do a video series on the Korean military vehicles, and I mostly only do a video if I have a chance at filming these vehicles in person. So I have to disappoint you, because that will only happen when I'm going to Korea in the near future.